Fayetteville, teen bullying has been grabbing headlines across the nation because it leads to suicides, depression, and high school dropouts. While it can be found in almost any school, today we met a local student who says there is almost no way to get relief. 4029's Rob Sneed sat down with the teen and heard her situation firsthand.
This 16-year-old says getting out of bed to attend Fayetteville High School is a daily struggle.
I used to cry like for 2 weeks, like every day. Like, at one point, I just wanted to just drop out of school because I hated going. It was just every day something new would happen.
She doesn't want to be identified out of fear of retaliation. She says she's been getting bullied for months by classmates who used to be her friends.
I never thought she was going to turn on me at all. Like, and I made a mistake, like, with trusting her.
The teen says the abuse is both physical and verbal.
Text messages, like, back and forth, like, bumping to me in the hallways, you know, eyes, like, getting too close.
She's not alone. According to the CDC, almost 30% of teens in the United States are estimated to be involved in school bullying as either a bully, a target of teen bullying, or both. Student privacy laws will not allow Fayetteville High School Principal Steve Jacoby to comment on the student's situation, but he says in bullying situations, swift action is taken.
And then we interview the students, the other students that are involved, and we take appropriate action.
Action that sometimes involves students signing a no-contact contract, but the student we talked to says it's one-sided and unfair.
If we have a Bulldog lobby that we always go to, and if they walk in, I have to leave. Or they come somewhere, I have to, you know, get my stuff and go in a different direction.
The teen has a message to the bully she says has made her life miserable.
And you don't know, like, what people are going through outside of school, like with their personal problems and things. So you just never know.
Rob Sneed, 4029 News.
And the teen says she doesn't expect the bullying to stop, but she hopes one day they will all sit down and hash out their differences so they can move on.